Tempest versus Future Combat Air System, FCAS, 6th Generation Fighter Comparison. Two consortia of European nations are developing a program for the Future Combat Air System. The British-led initiative is advancing more rapidly than the Franco-German one, but both still need to be completed, which looks like a difficult task due to internal squabbling. Six European nations have opted to develop a Future Combat Air System and enter the competition for next-generation aircraft over the past 5 years. On the one hand, the United Kingdom, Italy, and Sweden are creating Tempest, a system of systems centered around the eponymous fighter. On the other hand, Germany, France, and Spain have committed to developing a Future Combat Air System, FCAS. The two programs will be created within a comparable timeframe, but their technical characteristics, particularly their status, will not be the same. The Franco-German-Spanish-led Future Combat Air System, FCAS, next-generation fighter effort will not be following the approach of the rival Global Combat Air Programme by opening up partner nation and industrial collaborations to non-European parties. On other hand, the United Kingdom, Japan, and Italy will team up to jointly develop a new stealth fighter jet. A new international coalition sees broad collaboration from all three countries under what is known as the Global Combat Air Programme, GCAP. Its ultimate aim is to have a sixth-generation air platform in the air by 2035. A British-led stealth fighter effort, dubbed Team Tempest, was originally launched in 2018, with Leonardo's UK-based division being involved from the start. What has now evolved into GCAP sees Italy join the project on a national level with defence contractors Avio Aero, Elettronica, and MBDA Italia now also involved. As for Japan, it had long been seen as a potential partner, but confirmation of its involvement in GCAP heralds the most significant UK-Japanese defence collaboration yet and will be hoped to bring major cost-sharing benefits. FCAS, on the other hand, will continue as a fully European initiative, according to Airbus officials, at least for the foreseeable future. "We are not going to sign something with another non-European country in the next couple of years," said Michael Schoelhorn, CEO of Airbus Defence and Space, during the manufacturer's two-day trade media briefing held this week in Spain. Schoelhorn also revealed that there's not going to be anything outside of Europe relating to the newly signed Phase 1B demonstrator contract that paves the way for Airbus and France's Dassault to develop a first version of the FCAS, next-generation fighter. The two European programs to develop the sixth-generation air combat systems, the Tempest and the Future Combat Air System, FCAS, are running in parallel for now and are future competitors, but in a few years this situation could change. The two programs are currently in their conceptual phase. It is normal that, in this initial period, each country evaluates options in terms of technology. But it is natural that these two realities merge into one, because investing huge financial resources in two equivalent programs is unthinkable, Goretti told members of the parliamentary defence committees. While Britain is working on Tempest with a view to replacing its Eurofighter Typhoon aircraft from 2040, France, Germany and Spain are working on the rival, FCAS, project to replace the French Rafale and German and Spanish Eurofighters by the same period. European military and industrialists have often speculated that Europe might end up with a single program to pool limited budgets and avoid a repeat of the damaging effects of competition in the past. From a logical perspective, there is strength in numbers. Combining budgets and capabilities for the European NATO member countries, plus Sweden, makes a lot of sense and would maximize efforts. But experts also warn that any agreement to combine these strategic combat systems remains a long way off, as companies consolidate their positions in existing programs and Brexit remains a fresh political and diplomatic wound. In addition, analysts see the recent trilateral security pact between Australia, the United States and Britain, known as AUKUS, as another obstacle to meaningful cooperation on defence projects designed by and for Europe. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.